Good Friday, everybody. Joel here with you with the J7409 Tropical Update. Folks, I am fine. I am in a very serious mood. I am okay. I apologize for glitches and jumps in this video. My internet is terribly messed up. I'm lucky to even bring you a forecast, okay? I hope this works. Now, you see Lee. Folks, listen to everything I have to say right now, especially down in the Lesser Antilles areas, and be Puerto Rico, Bahamas, Turks, Caicos. You folks, please pay attention. Look at Lee. I want you to look. You can see an eye right there. Well, you know what? That eye is a little over 10 nautical miles wide. Okay? Now, Lee right now is a powerful Category 5 hurricane. Some things to me right now aren't adding up. I'm going to leave it at that. I know some of you think this may be a man-made storm. Some of you think it's not. Think whatever you want. I'll leave it at that. Although this hurricane is incredibly powerful, the wind field is not particularly large, and I don't understand that with the tropical storm force winds extending roughly 100 nautical miles from the center. Now, the Air Force hurricane hunters investigated Lee early in the morning today and found that the pressure has fallen to 926 millibars. 926 millibars. That is a powerful Category 5 hurricane, folks. Don't mess with it. Now, it's looking like some of these winds are going to keep going up. And since Lee is expected to remain in a favorable atmosphere, the conditions while moving over even the warmer waters during the next couple of days, it seems likely this hurricane will maintain its intensity and even become stronger during the next few days. Now, an eyewall replacement cycle will probably happen at some point. Now, these conditions cause fluctuations in the hurricane strength, and that's really hard to forecast, folks. But there likely will be some weakening beyond a few days. I don't see that coming right now until later next week. It may happen a little sooner. It might get into a little bit of shear, as I said in a previous forecast of mine. That will help. Regardless, though, Lee is expected to remain a very powerful hurricane during the next 2 to 4 days. Now, this hurricane has been on a steady west-northwest path. Now, we know it's been on this path for a while, and it's been steered by the flow on the south side of the subtropical ridge over the Atlantic. Now, right now, a continued west-northwest motion is expected, but a progressively slower pace is in the storm as it moves. I think it's going to move a lot slower coming up than it has been. Lee is expected in size to become more symmetric over this weekend and early next week as this hurricane starts to slow down. Listen to this. You know some of the waves I showed you in my previous forecast, like last week, about how high the waves are? Well, the recent wave altimeter data has showed peak significant wave heights between 45 and 50 feet. Can you imagine? These high seas are expected to continue near the core of the hurricane, and large swells will spread well away from this system coming up. This may happen today. Right now, there's still no watches and warnings out for any land. Just keep up with this, okay? Lee is a dangerous Category 5, and further strengthening is possible. The core is expected to move well north of the northern Leeward Islands, the Virgin Islands, and Puerto Rico this weekend or early next week. I think it might start this weekend, but I think the peak of it when it gets around you will be maybe Monday or Tuesday. Now, it's way too soon to know what level of impacts, if any, Lee might have along the U.S. coast and Atlantic Canada or Bermuda late next week, particularly since the hurricane is expected to slow down considerably over the southwestern Atlantic. Regardless, we know we are going to have dangerous rip currents. And folks, I'm just telling you, within the next 12 to 24 hours, these winds are going to get to 180 miles per hour. Checking in with the National Hurricane Center, here we have Lee. The winds now are 165 miles per hour. Pressure, 926 millibars. Located 17.8 north, 53.5 west. Still moving west-northwest at 14 miles per hour. Then we have Margo, tropical storm. I told you it would be one, and it may be a Category 1 hurricane before all is said and done. The winds in Margo are 40 miles per hour. The pressure is 1,004 millibars. It's located 17.4 north, 30.8 west, and it is moving west-northwest at 16 miles per hour. Here's the latest tracking map from the National Hurricane Center. Major, major, major hurricane. It doesn't matter where you look. This is going to be an awfully dangerous storm, and one to track that is unreal. It's going to be very hard to keep up with this thing as to what it might do due to certain factors coming up. Major hurricane all the way across. Look, for the northern Lesser Antilles, I would suggest, and this goes for Puerto Rico, right on up, not too much the Dominican Republic, but also Turks and the Caicos, southern Bahama Island chains right down here. As this storm begins to grow, just go ahead and prepare. Yeah, I'm telling you to prepare. Please don't be scared to death of this storm. You got to remain calm so you can think your way through this when these bad situations might occur. So please be ready for anything that comes your way. That's the best thing I can tell you right now, especially up in these areas here. Now, look, the forecast, you should not get a direct hit right now, but I do urge everyone, especially when it gets up here in these dots, because it can go anywhere it wants to. This is a pretty steady track through here. Should not have any direct impacts here. But this storm is so large. You see, this is the wind field. It doesn't look that big with this big of a storm with the winds in it. It's a wind maker, not necessarily a rain maker, but it's a wind maker. I can't understand why the wind field isn't much larger than this already. But with the wind field being the size it is now, when it goes across, it still, you can get some of the wind over in the northern areas here. I'm not saying it's going to be these 100 mile per hour winds. It may not be. More than likely, it won't be right now. But you will know it's there, and the surf and the beach erosion is going to be awful with rip currents. So please keep this in mind, and please keep up. Now, when we look at wind maybe occurring or start to occur where you live down in these areas, this is what it looks like right now. The storm is way over in this area, as you can see. But as this moves along, this wind may increase a little. Now, right now, down in these areas, you can see the dark green and the lighter green. That means you have only a 10% chance of feeling the wind. That's a small chance. But I think that will change and you may get up into the yellow before it's over. That would give you a 40 or 50% chance to feel the wind. So you need to be prepared forever, whatever is coming your way, period. Okay? And you can see over in this area along the Turks and the Caicos and the Southern Bahama Islet chains and in just all of these areas. Right now, it's only a 10 to 20% chance of you feeling tropical storm and hurricane winds, but I think that might increase to around 30 to 40 before all is said and done. So please be ready. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of models in this forecast. This is a serious storm. Please take it as that. Okay? Right now, this is what I'm thinking. Doesn't mean it's going to happen. It's what I'm thinking, okay? I have been over a lot of stuff, but it's way too far to know what's going to happen over here. Okay? This little dot right in here, that's Bermuda, okay? I think Lee is going to stay on this west-northwest track right on up. Now, around Wednesday, this coming Wednesday or Thursday, we better hope it's starting. Because if it doesn't, look out. I think it will turn. Where it's going to come in right now depends on a lot of things. We've talked about the jet stream and everything else. Still a little early to tell. So, I am thinking from like where I live down. Well, I'll say south of me, say New Bern, Wilmington. I don't think you're going to get any of this if we were to have a direct hit. And it's going to come up like this and come up like this. This is if we had a direct hit on the coast. Now, we might not have a direct hit. As a matter of fact, what it looks like right now, say from Boston, up in these areas here, a little pin back working again. From Boston, right on up in these areas and right on up into Canada. That is a very high chance right now. From Long Island down to the Delmarva Peninsula, that's a medium chance. And I'm thinking the Outer Banks and just south of the Outer Banks is a lower chance. This is just me, folks. It don't mean it's going to happen this way. I would strongly suggest for everyone in these areas to make sure you have some kind of preparations done and a plan made. Now, the storm should weaken some when it does come this way, if it comes this way, but it's still probably going to be a Category 1 or a Category 2. Now, it may not come this way. It may come up and go like this. Or it may come up and get a little closer to Bermuda. Bermuda, all of my friends in Bermuda. That's a small place. If you get hit by the storm, you're going to know it. Please, everybody there, prepare to. This is what it's looking like right now. Winds are going to get to 180 miles per hour, with the wind gust going to be over 200 miles per hour. For everyone, where this is at right now, this is what it's going to. There's no telling what the storm may do, and I'm not trying to scare anybody. You don't hear me talk like this unless I see this. My goodness, I told you how about the waves way last week. Now they've got them up to almost 50 foot high. Please stay aware and keep up with this storm. And I would suggest, I don't know what your beliefs are, but whatever they are, I would suggest for everyone to pray that this storm doesn't hit Bermuda or anybody on the eastern seaboard from North Carolina to Canada. We don't know what this storm is going to actually do until probably Tuesday or Wednesday. of this coming week. Be blessed, my friends. Please share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media. Please do that for me. And please stay safe. And may each of you have a lot of peace, love, and kindness in your life. I've been up a long time working on this, and I'm going to try to have you another update later this afternoon. This is what it's looking like now, and not a whole lot's going to change, I don't think. So that's all what it's looking like. Please stay safe. Thank you for everything you do for me, folks. I really appreciate donations, just watching my videos and sharing them. Thank you. Stay safe, my friends. God bless us all everywhere, and peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.